climate issues right now, amazing. You know, we now find out that the House just voted to overrule probably one of the biggest and most important climate protection laws that we had coming into place that would have reduced greenhouse gases by about 32% by 2030. Now, they knew that. They had all the facts. There was no guesswork. Even the industry admitted, yeah, it would reduce it by about 32% if we did these things, but we don't want to do them because they're too expensive. So the Republicans said, well, gee, we're going to give you a pass. You don't have to do these things. This is on the Clean Power Plan. What is your take on it?
Well, what's interesting about this is that industry, it is not too expensive. The technology to capture this carbon from the smokestacks is fairly inexpensive relatively because it's a one-time expenditure. They don't have to go out and repurchase equipment every single year. New power plants are already constructed with these devices in place. So this is not expensive. And the other talking point that Republicans use is, well, this is going to kill jobs. Well, again, turns out that these new regulations from the EPA are going to create far more jobs than could possibly
destroyed. And let's explain that. It's because of innovation.
Right.
Innovation creates jobs. Necessity creates jobs. Having to modify and change creates jobs. Alternative energy sources. That's why it's creating so many jobs.
Right.
But it's like a monkey watching television for these Republican types to understand that. And the worst thing is they understand it, but they're willing to kill their great-grandchildren and their children anyway. They're willing to kill the planet anyway just for a few dollars in their pocket. Not just, by the way, not just in campaign contributions. We find that the numbers of these cats that vote like this leave Congress and they go to work for these companies. They go to work for the industry.
They become lobbyists or they become, you know, consultants, which basically just means they tell them what to do. They give them a large check and then they go to their friends in government and try to, you know, ease regulations again through that method. But what's really disturbing here is that these Republicans, they understand that climate change is happening. Not all of them admit it, but they all do understand it. But more importantly, with this clean power rule, we're not just talking about, you know, global climate change. We're also talking about immediate environmental pollution that poisons the neighborhoods around these power plants. And the reason that they don't care about that is because these aren't wealthy, well-to-do neighborhoods around these power plants. They are low income, typically these people weren't able to go to college. They have very low paying jobs. And so those are the people that are being poisoned, but the politicians don't care because they don't live there. Their families don't live there.
The epidemiology is startling. The numbers of restrictive airways disease, asthma, COPD, all of the respiratory type of diseases you would expect are the very highest, by something like 40% higher than the normal population around these areas. So it is kind of a Soweto kind of thing. It's them. It's not us. It's kind of an economic apartheid, I think, is the best way I've heard it described. So these Republicans are all for any kind of apartheid.